Yo, what up, guys? Jason, Jason Thomas, and today we're back with another injury review. And today's injury review is on the Athlon Genesis Z8. Now, I know what you guys are thinking. Jason, when did you get a Z8? This is not mine. This is my friend Ricky's from the club, as you guys seen in Railway Show Tribute number 8. This is one of his locomotives. He's let me borrow it for a little while, or a little bit, and I'm making a review on it, like I promised. So, let's hop right onto it. Now, I don't have the box, and I don't have the manual, so I'm going off at least TV, like the functions 1 through 10, just for now, and maybe if he makes a video, he'll show the rest of it. But anyway, I think the Z8s were used for the Mountain Railway passes. Actually, I'm just going to look it up, because I know nothing about this engine, so I'm just going to look up the facts. But all I can say is it's a nice loco, and if you guys had seen it in the Railway Show Tribute, it pulls really well, runs really smoothly, and I say it couldn't be any better for an engine. But I'm going to look up what the Z8 did. Alright, so let's see what it gives me. This thing is no help at all. I looked up it. Okay. I don't know if I want to just really go over. You know what? So, in the White Knight Nation, a 4664 in the railroad steam locomotives have 4 leading wheels, followed by the 6 coupled drivers, which means, like, as you see, them being coupled together. They were used up in the mountains for either hauling coal, freight, passengers, but mostly it was a freight locomotive, and these engines were used to be articulated, so as you guys see, the front of it jiggles. Which I find is still good, so you can take in tight curves like 18 inch, but I think besides 18, that's the smallest you're gonna get. But let's hop right on into the functions. So function 1 is, actually no, 0 is the light, F1 is the bell, F2 is a long whistle, F3 are the short bursts, F4 is steam release, 5, if you look way back there, 5 is the cab interior lighting, and if you look back, I'm going to have to skip out of a function, 7 is the firebox light, and if we move right back on up here, if it'll allow me, we move back up. Oh my god. He doesn't want to focus. Hold on, guys. Alright, back. Sorry about that, you guys. F6 is the marker lights. F8 is to mute it. 9 is the gate crossing sequence. So I'll put on the bell so you guys can hear it. But I'll move it up a bit. So right now it's touching the buffer, so if you guys can read, it says Northern Pacific on the tender. Otherwise, oops, wrong way. You guys, slow little detail of the engine, which is a very nice detailed looking engine. So let's get into speed steps. So we'll back it 1, 2, 3, and 4, as you guys can see my other Athlon Genesis Challenger. And then we got 1, 2 with the bright headlight, 3, and 4. Put it back in the frame. So overall, I think this engine is a good engine. If I was to give it 1 out of 10, I'd give it about an 8. Actually, no, that's too cheap. I'll give it a 9 because on the traction tires, I don't know if they come with 4, but for mine, it comes with 2. Or for my friend, it comes with 2. 2 back here and none at the front. So it can pull it still can pull a decent amount being a Challenger. But I still think it's a good one. So we'll move it up, and then we'll end it off with a little run by going backwards. Hope you guys enjoy, and we'll see you guys in the next video.